H.P. Lovecraft called Clark Ashton Smith perhaps unexcelled by any other writer, dead or living. And that's a good enough reason to take a look at this singular writer, so let's have a look at Clark Ashton Smith. Clark Ashton Smith was born in 1890 in Long Valley, California, coming from an English background though. From a very young age, he displayed a great interest in writing and reading, which would probably have meant great academic success, though due to ill health, extreme shyness, and a reported fear of crowds, he only had minimal formal education and didn't even complete high school. For the most part, he was self-educated and reportedly had an eidetic memory. He had taught himself French and Spanish just so he could translate his writings into other languages, and was reportedly also quite good with Latin. Because of this eidetic memory that he supposedly had, his writings are known to have quite a big vocabulary to them. His main interest then was poetry, and he even became somewhat famous for his poems, even getting praised by Arthur Machen, and his first real collection sold very well. This all took place in his early 20s. However, his continued ill health, depression, shyness prevented him from really grabbing the opportunity. Financially, he was a lot like Lovecraft, just scraping by. His parents were still alive, but in constant ill health as well, and his mortgage was a constant pain. This forced him to do work beneath a person of his intellect, including chopping wood, picking fruits, digging wells, and occasionally office work like typing. Eventually, he became known to Lovecraft after Lovecraft wrote him a letter praising him for some of his poems. At this point, he put more effort, perhaps by Lovecraft's encouragement, into writing short stories, always in the genre of weird fiction and fantasy. He wrote a tremendous amount of stories, much more than Lovecraft did, and many were published in pulp magazines of the time, like Weird Tales, and this became his main source of income eventually, though it was still meager. Later in life, in the mid-1930s, his parents died, Lovecraft died, and it drove him into reclusiveness and depression. At this point, he started to practice other art forms such as painting and sculpting, mostly just for his own pleasure, but had given up the extensive writing of short stories then. He had a wife later in life, but died of a stroke soon after marrying in 1961. As a member of the Lovecraft Circle, he maintained a regular flow of correspondence with other members and, I dare say, led the literary style of living like Lovecraft did. Smith wasn't just a writer though. He was also known for exploring, in the latter part of his life, many other artistic mediums such as painting and sculpting. Whether he was very good at it, well, that's up to you to decide. He certainly has a unique style that is his own, and he doesn't try to be a brilliant artist, but I just think he's average. Smith's writing can be divided into three categories: poetry, prose poetry, and short stories. Smith considered himself firstly a poet. He started out as one and ended as one, and was quite acknowledged for it in his youth and won some awards and praise. However, I can't really comment on it because I'm not at all a poetry fan, but if you are, then you should know that The Hashish Eater is commonly listed as one of his best works. Next is his prose poetry, which I find more digestible. The benefit of prose poetry is the ability to tell snippets of stories or scenes which seek to instill a singular feeling in the reader without needing to conform to the rules of narrative fiction or conventional poetry. From what I've read of these poems, they tend to focus strongly on the human experience and emotions, but always set in some fantastical, weird, and cosmic setting. For example, The Abomination of Desolation features a horrific desert like the one the mad Arab Abdul al-Hazred might have roamed, and in the desert there can only be something described as a nameless mythos-type entity. But the poem is essentially about how the misery of loneliness, longing, and isolation disappear when you have somebody to love. Finally, his short stories. Smith's writings are almost always based in fantasy. Realism didn't have much appeal to him. To quote Smith, when chastised for his dedication to the weird and cosmic, he said, "I refuse to submit to the arid, earth-bound spirit of the time. Neither the ethics or the aesthetic of the anthill have any attraction to me." Interestingly, this is very much like what Lovecraft said when he said, "I could not write about ordinary people because I am not in the least interested in them. Man's relation to man does not captivate my fantasy. It is man's relation to the cosmos, to the unknown, which alone rouses in me the spark of creative imagination." Smith's stories in general can be subdivided into various settings he created. There is the Zothic cycle, the Hyperborean cycle, the Averroine cycle, and then some others which don't fit into any of these, sort of random stories he made. Zothic is an earthly realm in the far future. The sun is dying and civilization has slipped into barbarism, superstition, and sorcery and such things. Hyperborea is a realm from eons ago and also features sorcery and magic and such things, These stories tended to be a bit more sardonic in nature, and it is from this era that the Book of Ivan originates. Averoigne is a fictitious location set in medieval France, and these stories are much more orthodox in their subject matter. Think about ghosts, werewolves, vampires, that sort of thing. And lastly, he made some random stories, just like ones set on Mars or set on Earth. These things tend to be a bit more random and seem to be spontaneous in nature. It is important to note here that one mustn't think that Smith was just a mythos writer, a contributor to the Lovecraft mythos. His creations and fictional worlds are completely his own. Lovecraft merely appropriated a few creations for his own stories, as did Smith for his own stories, and Smith merely made a few stories that he wrote with Lovecraft's own mythos in mind. So for example, the Tsathoggwa you see mentioned in Lovecraft stories won't have all the same characteristics and interpretation of the Tsathoggwa in Smith's stories. Now, my opinion, I'm not a literary critic, so I will give you a few blunt impressions of his tales. And of course, though it might be unfair to Smith, I cannot help but instinctively use Lovecraft as a measuring stick. His writing style is not at all modern. I mean that his use of language makes me think of early 20th century writers like Lovecraft, Arthur Conan Doyle, Robert E. Howard, those types of guys. He used more dialogue than Lovecraft used, but of what you read mostly in his stories is just narration. At times in his more weird horror-focused stories, I read passages that reminded me of Lovecraft's style. You know what I mean, like how the protagonist describes how horrific the moment is in a flurry of adjectives. I like that. Also, some of his stories, like The Double Shadow, start out in a typical Lovecraft horror style, with a protagonist writing down by candlelight his horrific experiences in the hopes that they served as a warning to others, kind of like how Dagon started. Smith had a great grasp of language, and I must be ashamed to admit this, but I had to break out the dictionary occasionally. He differs from Lovecraft in that he much more often created 100% fantasy worlds with no connection to our reality. Even his Averoigne stories, which were basically supposed to be set in medieval France, rather just took the aesthetics of medieval France than actually setting them there, if you know what I mean. He stated, "I am far happier when I can create everything in a story. Maybe I haven't enough love for or interest in real places." So all his locations are completely fantastical, and he often gave them bizarre names as well. Lovecraft, on the other hand, preferred to highlight his supernatural elements by placing them in ordinary New England places. Even though places like Arkham and Kingsport are fictional, they basically really could be real places in New England. Admittedly, I much prefer Lovecraft's style. I know what New England is like, although I haven't been there, I know what I can imagine it in my head. Or with pirate fantasy, since I'm currently reading On Stranger Tides, I know what the Caribbean looks like, I've been there, and I know pictures about it, I've seen pictures of it, so I have no problem picturing these places in my mind. But with Smith, well, for example, in the story The Dark Eidolon, he talks of various locations like Zothic, Xylac, Umaos, Tasum, without going into much detail beyond saying this one is a city, that one is a desert. Now, if you've got a strong imagination, you can just fill in the blanks. But for me, maybe I'm too left brain orientated, but I need more information to successfully imagine these places. The solution I used for this is just to insert the imagery from other fictional places I can already picture in my mind's eye. Tasum is a desert in Zothic, you say? Well, now in my head, it looks like Tatooine, and Xylac is the bar with that catchy jazz tune. Long story short though, Smith is a good writer and he is enjoyable to read. It's just that he is more along the lines of a fantasy writer like Dunsany instead of a horror writer like Lovecraft. And I prefer Lovecraft, so there you go. If I have convinced you of Smith's quality and you are interested in reading him, then I highly recommend the Plinguin Classics edition titled The Dark Eidolon and Other Fantasies. It features the best examples of his short stories, poetry and prose poetry, plus an intro written by S.T. Joshi. If you are more interested solely in Smith's contributions to the mythos, then there is another option in the form of this book called The Clocashton Cycle, published by Chaosium and features an intro by the respectable Robert M. Price. I will put a link in the description where you can buy either of these books for less than 20 bucks, shipping included. If I had to choose 5 of his stories to recommend, then they would be The Vaults of Yovombis, The Nameless Offspring, The Hunters from Beyond, The Devotee of Evil, and Ubo Sathla. I must admit, I've only read about maybe 70% or 75% of all of these stories, so I haven't read all of them, but so far these are the ones that are really standing out to me as being pretty good. Keep in mind that I do have a bias towards horror, and these stories lean towards horror more than fantasy. Others might say that Smith wrote better stories, but these might be fantasy and just didn't appeal to me. There you go. So, that's my video on Clark Ashton Smith. My impression of him is that he was every bit as well bred and intelligent and sensitive as Lovecraft was. So I have nothing but respect for Clark Ashton Smith as a person, even though I don't really feel as drawn to his writings as I do to Lovecraft. If you really like Lovecraft's dream cycles stories, then you'll probably enjoy the rich fantasy of Smith. But if you just enjoy Lovecraft's horror, then Smith might be a bit of a letdown for you. If there's any other authors you'd like me to look at, let me know. Anyway, thanks for watching and stay Eldritch.